Legal experts say the federal investigation now turns full speed towards the seven NOPD officers involved in the shootings. All seven officers, you'll recall, were charged at the state level in 2008 with murder or attempted murder, but the case was thrown out because of misconduct by former DA Eddie Jordan's office. That aside, however, the officers are likely next on the federal agenda. My report is all new tonight.
Julian Murray, former assistant U.S. attorney and now prominent defense lawyer and college professor, says it's a logical progression.
You know, you got the sergeant, the investigator in between that they may go after next, but ultimately they're going after the seven shooters. I mean, you have the victims, surviving victims have already testified that they didn't have guns, and now you have Lieutenant Lohman saying they don't have guns. So the case is going to be pretty strong.
Murray says there are a number of possible charges the seven shooters could be faced with.
Number one, they could charge him with the cover-up itself without even going to the shooting, because those are very serious matters carrying very large sentences. But in all likelihood, what they're going to go after is a civil rights violation. They're acting under color of law as police officers, and you can't shoot people that are unarmed. So you go after a civil rights violation, and with death resulting, it could even be a life sentence.
Murray says it's a very serious matter for the officers involved, and he believes some of them will follow the lead of former Lieutenant Michael Lohman and cooperate with the feds.
I do believe that there could be other people who are going to break ranks. I mean, I just don't believe that all seven are going to hang in there together, because it comes a question of who's doing shooting. You know, I didn't shoot anybody, or I shot and I missed. So I think there's going to be a breaking of the ranks. It's just too serious a matter.
Now, despite the new developments in the case, Murray says he does not expect to see this case back in state court ever again, emphasizing the police and the DA don't need to go against each other. He adds, it's better for the federal government to handle these types of cases.